because CBD, Central Business District, in Bombay, what's that called? BKC, Bandra Kurla Complex will be all those big, big buildings there. Very good. So tall buildings are only for the rich, by the rich, for the rich, right? Because the maintenance cost is 25,000 rupees a month. Can any poor person who is removed from the, you know, Dharavi slums pay that much money? Nobody can pay. So it's not happening. Don't take that bluff anymore. Precast technologies, right? This is Gujarat earthquake, 6,000 school rooms built, 3,500 fell down during that. Precast technologies, untested. Show me one experiment done in this country, full-scale prototype, precast house before they are built. None. Let's not danger, I mean, put other people's lives in danger. If you are willing to live under that all through, then let's talk about it. If you are not, don't put other people's lives in danger. Open ground story, the more we talk about it, the more painful it gets. But just because the general manager's wife and daughter died in this building, Indian Oil Corporation today says across the country, no open ground story buildings. Right? There are some buildings in which the contractor didn't know, but the RC elevator shaft saved that building from falling down. Right? As I'm talking, three more buildings would have been finished, open ground story buildings, and one will be a hospital in that. Right? This is the only country in which the column size will remain the same throughout, from 1 story, 3 story, 5 story, 7 story, 11 story, 14 story, 22 stories will remain the same. This is a picture of 14 story. This is the only country. I told you Newton's laws are not applicable in this country. Yeah, they're applied elsewhere. And when earthquakes happen, we do retrofitting from floor to bottom of that beam. Right? We put even big, big I sections next to it from floor to bottom of that slab. We don't even connect it through. Earlier, car could be parked here, now bicycle can't be parked there. Right? Somebody puts, say, no, I need bracing, wall, this, that. But I think the first thing that all of us have to do quickly is remove all those cars and put walls, masonry walls and that quickly before it comes down on you. Life safety is the first thing. See, if you want, anything can happen. This is 1960s, 70s, and this is today, the same street. It's about desire. That one country desired and they moved forward. Do we desire? Is the question I'm placing before you as I stop for the day. As an engineer and architect, you need imagination, you need big picture, you need sense of geometry, you need design conception, you need nerves for execution, analytical capabilities, you need respect for safety, and you need common sense. Right? In the Indian context, two things are missing. This one, safety, and this one, common sense. With these two missing, the game is over. Right? We're all the time talking about finishes, and we are actually making hospitals with all this glass and so on, which could be very, very dangerous. We're focusing all the time in form, but what we should be worried is performance. And form is the architect's business, and performance is the life of this people of India. So we owe it to the people of India to make sure that their life is protected and is safe. We need to take every day as a sunrise, every day as an opportunity. We need to give owners at least the basics before they get misled by some company again and they get sold into buying something which is unsafe. We need to do a massive education campaign. And we don't need degree holders anymore. Right? We need graduates who are worthy, who are competent. And that is a very tall task. In fact, given a choice, I will get the architects and civil engineers married actually. Pardon? Keep guessing, bhai. You look at statistics in the two colleges and you'll know who is the architect and who is the engineer. But I think a professional marriage is required. Personal marriages may or may not happen up to their choice, but professional marriages must here. There's so much knowledge. You just need to implement that. You don't need to discover new knowledge here. Common sense is something that will take away 75% of the success and the rest of the details in time. But we have to work together, and we have to work with knowledge as power. Today, 2014, knowledge is indeed power. If the companies are taking away 51% of the equity of every profit, that's because they are carrying away the knowledge as the power for themselves. What is also necessary in this country is regulatory framework. We need mechanisms in place. If we don't have that, let us not do any more of this sham, tell that we are doing professional services. We are not doing professional services. We have to ask for regulation, and we need to be bound by the regulations that we ask for. Time has come for us to choose that we invest before the disaster and protect ourselves, or we pay after that. Being ready, being prepared is a must for all of us here, but the key question is that where are those people who will make the common man prepared? We need architects and engineers. We have 250 colleges of architecture and about 600 colleges of civil engineering. Tell me where they teach safety of masonry structures. That is what is worrisome today. We need to do a comprehensive overhaul of the education that we have in both architecture and engineering if we have to make our houses safe. Scientific knowledge is growing all through, and codes are getting updated, but they are not getting implemented. And so we need to work hard on that front. We need to develop a set of people who are professionals in housing safety and spread them across the country to give knowledge and support to not only the people but also to the governments that exist across. If we think that we don't know anything, we can get help from outside. And there are people, there are organizations which have done it already in the past to our neighboring countries, we can also learn from. There are different needs for urban and rural areas, and we need to recognize the difference, and we need to build in those formal methods for construction. We need a national housing group which will take policy decisions at the national level, that get implemented at the state level, and that get implemented at the regional level. And when you take a regional level look, there's a city level, municipal level housing task group. In the city of Hyderabad, Secunderabad, Twin Cities, we require a housing task force which will work towards safety of the people in this city, at least to begin with. Let us be an example in this country where there are no examples when you look over the shoulders. There are a number of responsibilities for this task force, and I'm hoping that these task groups will champion safety of housing and give the people of India the due respect for their lives. There is technological aspects, there's implementation aspects, and I'm hoping that we will do that soon. But what is worrisome most to me is that in India, political will is only at the highest level, but not percolating down to the subsequent levels of the governance. And that is where we need to do some hard work. The beneficiary is the benefactor. You're going to work hard, and you are going to reap the benefits of that. Don't feel ashamed, but this is the way this country will grow forward. You have to work hard. You have to till the land, sow the seeds, and reap the harvest also. What is also worrisome is that technologists are way behind today in the country, meaning the people who have knowledge or supposed to have knowledge are not giving that knowledge out, and the companies are doing a commercial market on this, and that's not good for us. I'm hoping to get away from today's practice and do something every year. In the next 3-4 years, we can make significant change in our own methods of construction or even education. We will see that we can make a difference. First, compliance is what we are doing today, and compliance of laws which are very weak. So you have to modify laws. And then from compliance, we move to competence. So we have to fall in rank and file and write an examination for licensing of engineers, and only then we should practice. Otherwise, we should not practice here in this country. And all this will continue to happen. This buildings will start falling apart. Let us not just watch them fall apart over time. If there is a small twig, let us remove it from the way and paint the line straight instead of saying, that is not my job. Right? I pray that we never have an occasion for an error of intention. Error of ignorance and error of execution is allowed, but error of intention is actually culpable under Indian Penal Code. So that is not a good situation for us. If you know that you have to do something, please do. Otherwise, it's not a good situation for you. Difficult task. We have 305 million houses. The houses have to increase over time. My question is, at least the new ones, make sure that they are disaster resistant. Some we will lose in the disasters to come. Those will get replaced by the new ones. You have to retrofit some of them and make sure that the unsafe stock comes down. The question is, what is the year in which we'll make India unsafe? That is where the difficult part is, that we need to fix a timeline and then move forward. I'm fixing 2050, 40 years or 35 years from today, and that's one full generation. We'll have to work very hard for it. I have few years left in my life. I will work hard towards that. I hope you will also join in making sure that houses are safe. We need to have a national technical community of housing specialists or housing personnel, housing enthusiasts, and let us use them to set the agenda and take it forward. And I'm hoping that it's not just an invitation, but at the end of the day, today you must have realized it's our responsibility to the people of India to provide them safe houses, to help them build their houses in time. Thank you again for your time and attention, and I invite you to build a bridge to the future. Yeah, if there are questions, I'd like to take them right now. Yeah. Thank you for the question. If you bring somebody from the temple, he will only sing his chanting mantras, right? He will not sing from Gurdwara anything, right? I come from this temple of earthquakes, so obviously I will tell you about earthquake story. If you want to hear about floods and typhoons and cyclones and all that, you bring another person, he'll tell you next year's housing theme can be cyclones and housing. Today. No, I'm not trying to wish away your question. I'm telling you very simply, remember, when it is a cyclone, the house will be lifted up and you will not see the house reminiscence. When it is an earthquake, you will see every part of the house fallen down there itself. Right? When it is a wave, you will see that the house will be pushed back into the land, and so you will see the part elsewhere. These are all contrasting demands. For example, in a cyclone condition, your roof has to be very heavy and your roof has to be anchored down to the ground, and the walls have to be very heavy to be able to hold that roof. Right? In an earthquake, in an airport, at a doctor, with a coolie wala in a railway station, remember one thing. Weight. Doctor is shouting at you, reduce your weight. Right? That air hostess is saying, aapke excess baggage hai. रेलवे स्टेशन में कूली कहता है 40 रुपए में क्या उठवा दोगे पर्वत उठवा दोगे मुझसे राइट यू गो टू अ डॉक्टर एंड सेज तुम तो कल मर जाओगे वेट कम करो एवरीवेयर वेट इज अ प्रॉब्लम बट इन साइक्लोनिक कंडीशंस वेट इज रिक्वायर्ड अब नाउ इज द टाइम फॉर यू टू ब्रिंग द बेस्ट इंजीनियर आउट ऑफ योरसेल्फ एंड टेल मी हाउ वुड यू बिल्ड अ हाउस इन द कोस्ट ऑफ इंडिया in which these cyclones keep coming in, especially on the eastern coast of India, Orissa and Andhra Pradesh. Give me one. Right? So you have a, are you doing PhD or something? I know. So if you have a desire change, civil engineering is a better place than computer science. Don't be in computer science. Come to civil engineering. We have very exciting projects here. Kosi floods, mein, you may have seen some models put outside there, and before I leave, I must mention here, I must leave a word of appreciation to all the young boys and girls who put in those models, and really, for a first effort of this institute, this is a great beginning, but I'm hoping that each year passing, your models will become that much more real, That means next time I want you to bring some reed from Assam and build your ekada houses with that reed and tell us how it is done originally. And that would be a challenge for the next year. This year you have shown us how they look. Next year you will tell us how they are built also in prototype, not full scale, reduced scale. Right? Now, in one of those models, you saw that there are stilted constructions. And then typically normal flood level will pass underneath. That is the classic thought in the floodplains of Kosi. But if you look at earthquake in that Himalayan region, when the bad earthquake happens, stilted constructions are not good. Right? Again, there is a contrast here. That is the reason why, if you really look at practice in the traditional knowledge times, they never mess with the floodplains. Housing is never built on the floodplains. And if you remember the Hindi movies of 1940s and 50s, some of them, people have to walk 6, 8, 10 kilometers to start work for the day and then come back. Today we don't want to do that. We want to be 1 meter away from our work. And so we are sitting plumb in the middle of the floodplains. I'll give you another disaster that's happening. In Sikkim, they built a dam on a river Tista. And it's a L-shaped bend in that river. So they built a dam there. And then they put the tunnel from the high position across the L in the remaining stretch of it. So the water is going there from the dam directly. And this L is empty, dry. So somebody got a brainwave and got approval of a municipal corporation to build housing in that middle of the river, because Kanchanjunga, Sidha Dekhben Dada, straight Kanchanjunga's view in the middle of the river. And it is sold. I'm not telling you a tall story here. It is sold. I'm glad it is not built yet. Right? So we are playing games. We must understand water knows only elevation. Low elevations, it will fill. 40% of Bombay is underwater if you have high tide and rain coming together. Why do you complain? Don't complain. Because you know that that is the situation before the high tide came. Right? In every town, there were lakes. In Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, I'll give you an example. Hyderabad also. Right? They had lakes, small water bodies and all that. Slowly with time, the population increased. We did a lot of groundwater, took away all that water, it became dry. So we built houses. We cut plots, municipality sold houses. Now, a little rain, the whole city is concrete jungle, water comes into the lowest point. Then you say, what is municipality doing? What is government doing? Government can't do anything, municipality can't do anything. You have messed with the nature. Don't mess with nature. I started with that statement. Look for a housing that is in sync with nature. If you are not in sync with nature, you have not built the correct house. Please, please, please watch nature. All of you should spend half an hour with nature every day. And then only you'll become better architects and engineers. Pre-engineered build. Today, pre-engineered is a misnomer in this country. There are companies which sell you pre-engineered. They have not tested any of those buildings. Because they have not, it has not been tested so far. You give me a pre-engineered building with a I section which is 6 inches deep and got a bolt on top and bottom. Take it to seismic zone 5 and run it down a magnitude 8 earthquake and tell me that it has withstood. We have not done testing. All these companies which are selling products in the country, if they have not tested, they should not sell. This is willful misconduct of professional services. You cannot give me a test of thermal conditions for earthquake safety.
The stat design, those are...
calculations, I told you that. Building that you saw, that precast housing, 3,500 school rooms fell down out of the 6,000. Stat calculations show that the building is safe. The company submitted a report saying that our building is safe after the earthquake when 3,500 school rooms fell down. Is that professional conduct? Don't get me on this. Don't test your buildings. Don't sell them. test your buildings full scale. Make one test facility in this country, which can test full scale, and let us talk precast buildings, let us talk pre-engineered buildings. Up to that time, don't talk precast and pre-engineered. It's a very, very dangerous game. You're putting other people's lives in that. You don't live in any precast, pre-engineered building. I know that. You live in RC frame building with open ground story.
No. Our
building, your route is different.
Our office itself.
Office chodiye sab, ghar ki baat karte. Next. Yes.
We can continue the discussion. Lunch, dinner is there.
So yeah, dinner is getting cold. This room is getting hot, that dinner is getting cold.
I'm a professor in architecture college.
Wonderful. Thank you, sir, for joining us.
Yes, thank you.
And I hope we have not caused much harm or injury to your thought.
No.
Okay.
There is a slight gap which is increasing between architects and civil engineers slowly in the student level itself. How can we integrate with that? We know the material, but technology, when it is coming to, Pradeep sir is already helping us in that, but how to integrate in a much
advanced way? Sir, the answer was there. You have to get them married. I told that.
Professionally.
See, we need to recognize one thing. In civil engineering education, there is no architecture component. And in architectural engineering, there is a lot of engineering component, but taught by colleagues who are already converted into architectural thinking. No. You need firebrand people from engineering side to go and say, nonsense, you can't build open ground story buildings. In your juries, if you get one of us sitting there, none of your juries will survive for half an hour. Right? Get one of us there. There are so many engineers in this room who are from the city. Get them to sit in your room, they'll just get you all sized up. No open ground story, no building with single column and all that flowery stuff on top of it.
Recently we introduced this structural engineers also in thesis,
in the jury.
In the jury
levels. Sure.
Thank you, sir.
I have to go.
Otherwise I won't get dinner.
Thank you very much for your time and attention. So please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your very big lecture and definitely very, very useful lecture. Please sit down, sir. I request Professor Govindarajulu, Registrar of RIPPLI Hyderabad, to felicitate Professor CVR Murthy. Please.
It was very thought-provoking talk, and I just now confessed to him that I'm scared of staying in multi-storied buildings in India. But one thing, for the engineering students, people, students entering the professional colleges, I think lectures like this, particularly by Professor Murthy, will be quite inspiring, and many people I'm sure will prefer specializing in civil engineering rather than carried away by the IT. I think that's a and he also rightly perhaps criticized the faculty with regard to the curriculum that we have in general in engineering. When I was doing my first year engineering, we had building materials as a course from Andhra University way back in 1961. Building construction also we had one subject right at the first year. And we also cursed the A series and B series drawings that we have drawn, but we were immatures. So we need a thorough shake-up of the curriculum and engineering education in this country. But let me also confess, I am pessimistic. We all know, he says, that there are the codes, the engineers, the professionals who certify in the municipal offices, and still we have these problems. Can we have a change of attitude? He said the lone man 67 years ago has said self-reliance. Is it that we should have this at the top level getting percolated to the lower levels? I don't know where it has to begin. I think we are all responsible and we all have to pay for any negative effects. I mean, I don't want to take much of your time. Thank you very much. It's a great honor to be here.
Now it's my pleasant duty to propose vote of thanks. So in one sentence, I thank everybody who are responsible for working for this event, especially student volunteers and all the guests who came and stayed here. And just this one I wanted to tell. So we are trying to build this portal or website that is where we are thinking to put all the building technologies, Indian building technologies.